Good morning, everybody. It's Pamela. This morning, I'm going to do a little shout out here. I'm in the kitchen, but it's food for thought. This recipe is, I've got kind of some music in the background with nature, wolves singing, and maybe some horses running through or rain. Just to calm me down to talk about this subject a lot of people don't want to talk about, you know, while I'm fixing my hair. And the topic today is dealing with in your family a person that's addicted. We're talking about people that have addictions with drugs. I'm talking about it. I'm going to be talking about drug addictions, alcohol addictions, people I've been involved with it. I'm going to talk a little fast here so I can get my shout out up. And this wolf that's on right now, my nature Alexa, is really interesting because it's how I feel. It's kind of like a faraway thing, but close. Because these people in your family that you may know that are addicted, it's really sad because they're manipulators. First of all, they have a disease. And if we're not aware of that, then we're not able to take care of ourselves. They will just destroy you. Your emotions, your well-being, but they're not, until they can realize that they have a disease and that they need help, you have to be aware of these people. I mean, they're in your family. There's a lot of them that are close to you. They've, you know, met people that are addicts and addicted, and we have to, at some point, pull back and honestly, look at our lives and how they're affecting us. The addicts that I've met and have affected me, before I realized that, you know, Pamela, you can do something about this, were immediate family. Then sometimes your immediate family meets people that are addicted to alcohol and drugs. And sometimes they hide it. You know, sometimes they can, you know, camouflage it for years and years. But it eventually comes out. And the sad part about it is the people that don't realize they can actually get some help, okay? And that they're destroying themselves first. But they will play a huge rainstorm on you that's like going. I mean, hail and victims and, you know, making you feel like it's your fault because of what you've done. And you get to the point where you're just like saying to yourself, well, you've done this too, and you've done that too, and that's this back and forth thing going on for years, because I've dealt with alcoholics and drug addicts, and they want you to feel really bad about who you are and why they have a problem with drinking. All their excuses, to be honest with you, they're not responsible. Until they get help and clear their mind, they can't do anything. Everything leads back to their addiction, okay? They can't usually, you know, handle jobs for very long. They're not responsible to do big things like own homes, get to places without you, you know, getting it for them, only to destroy you and think, okay, so I'm going to buy this person a big house. Am I going to be with them? Is she going to be with another man? Did I buy this home for somebody else's life? These things you got to take into accountability. Are you with an addict? Are you with somebody that can't get help and have been hiding it? They can't build bridges and get along with family members. So take care of yourself today. I'm not a perfect person, but I am not addicted to alcohol or drugs. And I've been around a lot of people that are. And the first one I ever met, not to have such a long shout out, I'm just being honest, was my mother. Okay, she was an addict, and I was a child, and I remember the pills being around the house because she was a registered nurse. And I thought, you know, Mom, all these pills, they got somebody else's name on them. So as a young girl, she said, well, they died and they don't need them. So I've dealt with addicts for most of my life, and it's definitely a disease. It definitely will take over on one's, you know, life that's not using, that's dealing with people like this. So it's okay if you're with an addict and you're telling them no. You're questioning them. You're waiting for them to step up and, you know, identify with what's wrong with their self. I mean, pretty soon there's just nobody in their lives. They've ghosted people. They don't want anything to do with people. And they're very demanding, very manipulative, and very unhealthy. Unhealthy for others that love them. So if you're caught up in that today, take a word of wisdom from Pamela that's been there. I know. I've been around drug addicts. I've been around alcohols. You can smell it. It's just coming out of their pores. It's in their breath. Their actions, their lips are always kind of cold. It's sad, but at the same time, we can't rescue them. We can't help them. We can only plant a few seeds and say, you need to get some help. And then we'll kind of like see where you're going. That's why when you meet addicts and things, they'll say, oh, I got 3 years, so that's great. I got like double that or triple that with people, you know, that have addictions. Sometimes a lot of people that are addicts and they're all together drinking their coffee and saying we didn't use today. That's great. But there's a lot of people out there that have been used and abused by the addict with the disease. I mean, I can't imagine drinking every day and it not making you dizzy or, you know. But for an alcoholic and a drug addict, it kind of levels them out. So that right there should tell you something. If you're drinking and you're not dizzy anymore, and you're drinking because it makes you feel better, remember that first drink you took? It made you dizzy. It made you woozy. And it grabbed you. Now you have a disease. So this is Pamela saying, if you got an addict in your life, first of all, take care of yourself. Second of all, know that they're not responsible. They come off like they are, and they want a lot of things, but all leads back to their addiction. So as Pamela is saying, love yourself today. Work through issues with addicts and people that use drugs. And don't let them camouflage you into doing things that you wouldn't normally do for a person that is sober and has realized they need some help. Okay, anybody's quick to say it, but remember that fruit tree in the Bible they talk about. How do you know that's an apple tree? Well, there's an apple. How do you know someone's not drinking or using drugs anymore? They're in programs. They've admitted it. They're not hiding it. So, and still at that, it destroys marriages, destroys love. It destroys a lot of things that people aren't willing to look at the other side of the coin and the table. So instead of feeling sorry for an addict that you love or is in your life today, stand up for yourself, take care of yourself, and it's Pamela saying, shalom, and be good to yourself, will you? Don't let a lot of people that are using drugs or alcohol destroy you as they're destroying themselves. Hold them accountable to have a better life that God gave to them. It's Pamela saying, peace.